Number two, the following are the threefold aims of investigation. Except one, letter A, to provide evidence for the offender's guilt, to locate the offender, to identify the offender, or to examine the evidences found at the crime scene. So, unsa man ang threefold aims? Or katong three phases?
Or ma'am, wala ABC,
ma'am. Katong three phases?
ABC, ma'am.
Phases of investigation. Katong ABC.
ABC, ma'am. Except B.
So, ang except man ang ginapangita, katong to examine the evidences found at the crime scene. Letter D ang answer ani ha. Kay ang threefold aims nato or three phases of criminal investigation is to identify the offender. Kaduha is to locate the offender. And ikatulo is to provide evidence for the offender's guilt. So, ka-exempt man ginapangita, letter D ang answer. Number three, what are the tools of investigation? So, tools na po daang ipangita. Unsa may answer ani?
Choices, ma'am.
Letter A, information, interrogation and interview, and instrument. Letter B, interrogation, interview, and information. Letter C, information, interview and instrument. Letter D, information, interrogation and interview. And last is instrumentation.
Letter D.
Letter D. Yes. So, manang answer. Number four, it is the knowledge which the investigator gathered and acquired from other persons. So, unsa may answer ani? Information, interview, interrogation or instrumentation?
Information.
Letter A, correct. So information ang answer ani. An information coming from records and files of the police, company records, civic spirited citizens. Unsa man ini sources? Regular sources, cultivated sources, grapevine sources, or poisonous sources?
Considerated, ma'am.
Regular, ma'am.
Masa considerated picture ba?
Sorry, ma'am. Mali, dai.
Regular, cultivated, grapevine, or poisonous?
Cultivated,
ma'am.
So, ang answer dari is regular sources. Kay, kuan naman siya, gikan naman siya sa police files, company records, or kanang mga citizens na nag-report. So, mauna siyang mga regular sources. So, kaning number 6, an information coming from paid informants, bartenders, cab drivers, or ginatawag na to ng mga informers or assets. So, may tawag ani sa ilaha?
Cultivated.
Regular, cultivated, grapevine informers. So, tama to siya. Mauning cultivated sources. Kay mga binayran man ni sila ng mga informants. Number 6, ay 7 na day. These are information coming from the underworld characters such as prisoners and ex-convicts. Letter A, underworld. B, cultivated. C, grapevine. D, informers.
Grapevine, ma'am.
Yes, correct. So, grapevine. Letter C. Tama inyong answer? Tama inyong answer, mali.
Taminaw
na mo.
Tama, ma'am.
sure, ha? So, basta underworld gani na characters nagikan sa mga prisoners or kanang mga ex-convicts, gikan sa ilaha na information, ginatawag ana is grapevine sources. So, para sa mga investigator, tamis kay na para sa ilaha. Kay syempre, kana na mga tao is, basin di ay naa sila'y connection ato na suspect or naa sila'y nahibalan about ato. Kay syempre, naay ubang mga prisoners diha, daghan kaayog mga connection. So, para sa ilaha, tamis mong ginatawag siya na grapevine sources. Number 8, it refers to asking questions to the witness of crime in order to extract information from them so that perpetrator could be apprehended. Investigation, interrogation, interview, or criminal interrogation. Say answer.
Investigation, ma'am.
Interview, ma'am.
Letter C. Interview. So, if you are asking question kay witness, interview na siya, ha? Maka-ask, maka-question kay... maka-interview, baka makakandak, maka-interview kay suspect? Oo, dili. Yes or no? Makakandak, maka-interview kay suspect?
No, ma'am.
Yes, no. So, ang interview is intended only kay witness. Kay ang suspect manggod pag mag-ask kag question, interrogation na ang tawag ana. So, if you are asking a question kay witness, interview. And if you are asking a question kay suspect, interrogation. Oh, na siya ayahang kalahian. So, number 9, you are asking a question to a person suspected. So, interrogation, answer ani. Letter B. Number 10, one of the most important aspects of securing the crime scene is to preserve the scene with minimal contamination and disturbance of physical evidence. So, mo na siyang pinaka isa sa mga important na aspect pag mag-secure ka og crime scene. Siyempre, i-preserve judayon ni mo ang crime scene. Diba? Mawatun nyo ang gibuhat. Katong buhat mo atong processing the crime scene. Gi-cordon dayon ninyo ang crime scene para ma-preserve og dili ma-contaminate ato ang crime scene. Number 11, the scene blank provides an overview of the entire scene, identifies any threats to scene integrity, and ensures protection of physical evidence. So may answer, walkthrough, cordon, entry, exit, or assessment. So answer.
Walkthrough, ma'am.
Yes, walkthrough. Ang walkthrough, ang kadalasang nagabuhat ana is kanang mga team leader or officer in charge. So ang walkthrough is wala na siya nag-survey sila sa crime scene. So buhatan ana niya is magbuhat siya entrance kung asa muagi ang mga investigators. So magbuhat siya entrance og exit na para dili ma-contaminate ang crime scene. Mao na siyang walkthrough. Asa na? Number 12, below are the purposes of interrogation. Except ha, letter A, to obtain confession to the witness of the crime. Letter B, to induce the suspect to make admission. Letter C, to learn the facts of the crime. Letter D, to learn the identity of the accomplice. Except asa man, A, B, or C, or D.
Letter B, ma'am. B, ma'am.
B?
B.
Ang uban, ano sa answer ninyo?
A, ma'am.
Yes, very good. Letter A. Kay interrogation. Interrogation man atong ginapangutana dire, di ba? Si interrogation is kay suspect na siya. Ang nakabutang sa letter A, to obtain confession to the witness of the crime. So, mali siya. Ay suspect man ta kay if ang interrogation, di ba, intended only kay suspect. So, letter A ang answer ani. Mali man siya. Witness man ang nakabutang. Number 13, these are very important in crime scene investigation and in interview and interrogation. The keen power of observation and description, the power to read between the lines, knowledgeable, good in oral and written communication. Say answer.
A, ma'am.
Yes, letter A. The keen power of observation and description. So, importante na siya sa crime scene investigation kay dapat as an investigator, kabalo ka mo observe sa naa sa crime scene or sa mga tao nga mo adto or mo exit diha sa crime scene kay base na adra si suspect. Kung sa interview o interrogation, dapat obserbahan pud ni mo sila the way sila mo istorya. Kung nagapamakak ba gyud siya or tinuod ba ni iyahang ginaingon. So, as an investigator, dapat naakay the keen power of observation and description. Number 14, this is the ability of the investigator as he mingle with the community or in making a concise report. Murag na short na ang question dere. So, answer ani? Keen power of observation, power to read between the lines, knowledgeable, or good in oral and written communication?
Ay, di po ma'am, di.
Letter?
D.
Bravo. Ano sa ganito number?
Delta po ma'am, Delta.
Ay, Delta. Yes, correct. So, from sa question, makita man nimo siya, no, as he mingle with the community. So, dapat hawod ka sa, hawod ka makipag-communicate sa tao. Dapat na akay good relationship sa community kay para makakuha ka og additional information sa ilaha. Kay kung maldito ka na investigator, dili na hinuon makipag-cooperate si ang tao sa imuha or ang community. Dili na noon ka makakuha og additional information. Dapat as an investigator, you are good in oral and written communication. So, written communication, kanang mga reports. Diba? Kay nagabuhat pong reports sa mga investigator. Kay ipasa man na sa ilahang head, sa prosecutor, or sa atuang korte. So, dapat kabalo ka mabuhat pong reports. Number 16, this is the ability of the investigator to interpret the words or phrases encountered in the process of investigation in their deeper meaning in order to arrive in an accurate meaning of a certain statement. Letter A, the keen power of observation and description. Letter B, the power to read between the lines. Letter C, knowledgeable. Letter D, good in oral and written communication. Ano sa may answer?
Bravo, Letter B, ma'am.
Yes. Bravo, the power to read between the lines. So, pasabot aning the power to read between the lines is kanang naay giistorya si wala niya gi-direct ingon ang nahitabo or kung kinsa nang suspect, murag na siya'y laing statement nga gibutang. So, as an investigator, dapat kabalo ka unsaon nimo pag-decipher ana or pag-decode sa iyahang statement. Or sa ato ang crime scene investigation, naa siya gibutang diha na number. So, para sa investigator, mura na siya codes, passwords, or unsa ba tawag, or puzzle na nakabutang sa ato ang crime scene. Gibutang niya diha is number. So, para di ito kay witness, pangalan di ito siya ni suspect. So, as an investigator, dapat kabalok ka unsaon to siya pag buhat og deeper meaning ato. Mao na siyang read between the lines. Sana number 17. This is very important in order that the investigator could easily decipher falsehood from truth and separate the gain from the chaff. Letter A, the keen power of observation and description. Letter B, the power to read between the lines. Letter C, the intelligence and wisdom of Solomon. Letter D, good in oral and written communication. Ang say answer?
Letter C, ma'am.
Yes.
Letter C, ma'am.
Yes, very good. So, letter C. So, kabalo na ba mo sa story ni King Solomon? Kabalo mo sa story ni King Solomon? Kabalo mo wala?
Na, ma'am, ang
story ni King Solomon sa Bible.
Ay, wala, ma'am.
So, ingani ang story ni King Solomon. Nga nung ingani ni siya, the intelligence and wisdom of King Solomon. So, kato na time, katong bag-on ni lingkod si Solomon as a king, na ay duha ka mother. Si Mother A o si Mother B. Si Mother A, namatay iyahang anak. Si Mother B, buhi. Pero si Mother A, gikawat niya ang anak ni Mother B. Siyempre, si Mother B, wala ni sugot. Eh, siyempre, nahibalaan niya ang anak niya tong kay Mother A nga gikuha. So, nag-away silang duha. Then, niadto sila kay King Solomon. Naabot ang balita kay King Solomon. Niadto sila dito asa kaharian ni King Solomon. So, pagkakuan, ang gidesisyon ni King Solomon, sige, ingani atong buhaton. Tungaon na to ang lawas sa bata. Kanya-kanya muog lubong sa lawas sa bata. So, si Mother A, nisugot. Si Mother B, syempre, as a mother, dili ka musugot na mamatay imuhang anak. So, nisugot si, ay, ang ingon ni Mother B is, ihatag na lang tong, ihatag na lang ang bata kay